Jonathan Paula presents Game Time. Let's play the spam.
My name is John. Welcome to Let's Play the Spam. It's time to check my inbox folder for any more unsolicited game offers I've received. And this one from Jua, founder of Umbu Game, wants us to play Death's Life, the game version of the Final Destination movies. In Death's Life, you're the new apprentice for Death, the Grim Reaper. It is your job to help gather souls, but you must do this look like natural, using intricate chain reactions to create dangerous and fun accidents, as in the Final Destination movie. You had me at playing as Death. This sounds like a really cool concept. And about a week ago, I watched the old Swedish film starring Max von Sydow, The Seventh Seal, which is about the Grim Reaper and Death. And I didn't really care for it. So I need a little part of my life involving the Grim Reaper not to suck this week. So let's check out Death's Life from Umbu Games. New game. Kitchen. Never worked. Likes to hurt turtles. Loves... Oh, this guy has to die now. This guy is going downtown. And by downtown, I mean inside the grave. Oh, we can pick a level. Workshop. Mad scientist. Experiments with beasts. Fears rabbits. All right. So there's a host of things we can do. Let's just start with the inaugural installment. The first episode we saw, which was this guy. Little... Mario brother here. I wonder if the other ones are analogous to other types of characters. Well, this is an Oompa Loompa, clearly. All right, this one, that's your Breaking Bad. This, that looks like a Homer Simpson. Enjoys good beer. Mistreats and best loves. Can't say I recognize that one off the top of my head. This is Ash Ketchum from Pokemon. Alright, that looked like, Pulp Fiction, for sure. Alright, so there's a lot of fun little jokey jokes in this. So let's start with Mario, a new recruit. Welcome, I must teach you how to do your job. It's simple. You must kill your victims or make it look like an accident first. For this, you must create a chain reaction rearranging the objects in the scene. Alright, let's go for it. Let's go for it. What do we got here? First object. What did I do? What's happened? What have I done? What do I do with this? Have I done it? What needs to be done? All right, so all the objects are moved? I think I'm missing the element of this that's a game. Oh, start here. Okay. You are getting closer. Attempts. 1. Found 6. Replay. Well, how am I supposed to kill him if I don't know where he is? Killer object. First object. So this needs to be here so it can fall, and it's gonna bump onto this, and this thing's gonna knock over this... the broom, and then that hits the knife, and then the knife flips up and let's try it. Oh, it's rolling? Oh, okay. Almost there, just a little bit. Alright, so we gotta set these up like this. Let's try this now. Wow, this is like I'm directing my own Final Destination movie. Oh, you are very close. The victory is imminent. Alright, ding dong, pip pop. Let's try it. Oh, here we go. The angle change, which means we got it. Oh no! Oh, water everywhere! It's-a me, Mario! Here we die! You think you beat me. But, Oh! That was more satisfying than I had predicted. Thank you for that. Congratulations, you did it! All right, not bad at all. So let's check out the next level. Another job well done. So we've knocked off Mario, and now we get to pick our next victim. Let's go with Homer J. Simpson here. Do I get to actually pick the... Well, I guess we have to go in sequence, whatever. I don't know who this is. Let's just call him Dom Toretto and pretend we're in Fast and the Furious. Loves killer cars, steal car parts, and cheats people. Oh. Oh, well, that's not gonna be friendly, huh? All right, so he's under the car. I'm guessing we need to... So is it just finding the objects that can be moved and then moving them? Almost there, just a little bit. Is it, so this is the start object. You knock over the traffic cones and death begins its knock. Oh no. Knock it. Bingo. Bongo. Fuck you. Bomb. Pitch. Bomb. Oh, I'm dead. That's too bad for him. Now there's a pool of blood under his car. And, he'll never get that oil changed now. Congratulations, you did it! Alright, so far, I'm digging this game. It's inventive. I kind of like the style. I don't know that the music fits, really. But it's limited. I mean, this is an indie title. I got a demo of it for free. I'm not expecting this giant involved game. But I feel like just clicking an object from position one to position two, there's not a lot of interactivity there, but I'm enjoying it. And that counts for a lot. Laboratory, mad scientist, experiments with beasts, fears rabbits. So there's a rabbit, there's a little blueprint of a, it looks like a grate. So we gotta put a rabbit on, oh, it's not a grate, it's a cage. So the footprints just showed us where he's gonna walk, I guess. And I think what's kind of frustrating right now is I understand I have to move objects in a certain way that they sort of Rube Goldberg into a death trap, but the relationship and causality of those actions is not clear just from looking at this 3D environment. Like, turning this beaker holder on its side, I don't know how that affects the relationship to the objects around it yet. So I'm just sliding things around, hoping that they have some general purpose. Like, what did I just do there? Oh my. Almost there! All right, so did I do that right? Oh, okay, so I want it to go this way. Now, air conditioner drop, red beaker explodes, shrapnel pushes that thing over. But did that release the bunny? What final element? Ah, okay. This will slide into this, and then this, I don't know what each of these objects are. I feel like a little tooltip that popped up and said, you know, this is what happened. It might be helpful. I don't know how many tries I get. I've used two so far. All right, so the red beaker explodes, shatters the green thing, mist over it, falls down, knock, knock. Who's there? Death is coming to kill you. This guy back, like this, I don't know. Oh, this is it, we got it. Explosion, mist, green falls, it slides around. Oh, and it gives the bunny the pill. See, I didn't know that was a pill bottle. I didn't know what was gonna happen. Now the bunny is, you know, possessed by the body of Glenn Close, and it's gonna go sort of ape shit on this guy's butt. Oh no, it's a rabbit. Look out, ah! Oh, well, oh, wow, okay, that was, yeah, wow, that was graphic. I thought maybe just, you know, trachery, artery, whatever this thing is called, I just figured that he would bleed to death. But instant decapitation, that's also acceptable. We'll take it. Another job, well done. All right, let's try out another episode here. Park, is that his name or is that the location? I guess the location. Loves cinema, sadistic, hates birds. Okay, so this looks like your Alfred Hitchcock type. I think that's who this is supposed to be. They're not all figures of fiction, I guess. I feel like this is supposed to be analogous to Hitchcock, but maybe I'm just sort of telegraphing because I've been watching a lot of Hitchcock films lately. You can break some objects to complete the level. All right. I don't know which objects I'm supposed to break. All right, so we're going to move that. So this will roll down and bump into this and then knock this. So this spins and then this guy falls over and then this, I don't, pop, boop, beep, pop, and then it falls in. I don't know. I have no idea. Let's try it. But I do like that he's gonna get killed by like a psycho statue. The psycho statue. Yes, okay. And go, go, gadget basketball. Kill Alfred Hitchcock. Bounce, up, comes back, hits this. Oh, and he was killed by popcorn, of course. Just like in Trolls 2. Wow. That's gonna be his last picture of the night. Oh, oh Jesus. I feel like I had nothing to do with the birds eating a skeleton away. But again, I'll take it. Next! Next! All right, what do we got? Let's try this guy. Who's this? Who's this, turdmonger? I'm Death and I'm coming for you. Amazing friend, likes ping pong, loves to run, and this is Forrest Gump. Okay, so let's strap into the SS Jenny and see if we can't knock old Forrest Gump into the water. All right, turn that hook, turn this thing. Gotta make that thing right there, gotta do that right there. Bam, dip-a-dip, dip-a-dip, bop. So some of these objects you don't wanna move, some of them you do. Right, what's, oh, this. Woo! So that was a big nothing. I got less of them, correct. Ow. Ow. This is kind of why I don't know if I like this game, because I'm doing things, but I don't really understand how they're being... Oh, no! Oh, I almost got him! Ooh! Ooh, ooh, ooh. I don't know. Let's try it now. He ducked. Why does Forrest duck? Let's just do that. Let's just see what happens. Okay, here we go. Oh, Jesus. Oh my gosh. Is his head gonna pop off? I just killed Forrest Gump. I feel like that's gonna be the title of this episode. I killed Forrest Gump. Sorry. Sorry about that. All right, let's do the Oompa Loompa episode. Level. I keep calling them episodes. Because I feel like little videos. Factory. Very small person. Likes coca. Sabotages factories. All right. So this is Oompa Loompa. This will be our final level. See if I can do it. You can choose the activation time of some objects. All right. So this game's introducing a lot of mechanics, making it harder as we go. I appreciate that. And now there are 10 objects we got to futz around with. Move that to the side. Move that here. Move this over there. Mayor. Bam. 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 Dip. Dip. Let's do all this right there like this. Oh, that was actually the start episode. Oh, the start item. I don't know. What do these guys do? It'll hit the switch. Put that on a delay. I don't know. I don't know what I'm doing. I don't know what's going on. Bing, bong, bing, bing, pong. All right. 2 second delay, and then one of these. I don't know, man. I don't know. I'm trying to kill this Oompa Loompa. Oh, he's right there. I didn't even know he was in the shot. You are close. Victory is imminent. Change it to one. Oh, here we go. Oh no! Oh no! Look out! Oh no! Look out, Oompa Loompa! Oh no! My God! Oh my God! His face is gonna. Oh my God! We killed him. I'm not sorry. Clearly, if death is knocking on your door, you deserve to die. That's the end of that chapter. I have to say, this is kind of a fun game. That's called Death's Life by Umbu Games. I kind of enjoyed it. I think as a quick kind of a couple hours of enjoyment, you can't go wrong. I don't know that this game is going to offer you a lot of replay value, though, and I feel like while there is like a good selection of levels, I played through the first 6 or 7, there was only like 20 total, so I feel like in one short afternoon, you'd probably finish this entire game. But again, to be fair, this is not a AAA title. It's something really small from like probably a small group of people, and I think they did a good job on this. I kind of liked it. I thought it was really fun. And the fact that the deaths are really perverse and bloody and gory, I think that makes worth playing, because it's a lot like Surgeon Simulator, except you're doing all of the death and the mutilation and the decapitation on purpose. So that'll be it for this episode of Let's Play the Spam. My name is John. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.